Anglais, mieux pour moi. I've been covering the Arab Spring since the really beginning in Tunisia in January 2011. And I'm also a member of the Catalan Journalist Association. So I have, I think, a message to bring to this seminar about how to organize journalism in a democratic state and the experience we have endured here in Catalonia throughout democracy, from the transition and even today. Because nothing is for granted, and as soon as you gain a new freedom, you have to fight for it. And you have to fight for it every day. And that's what we do at this Catalan Association for Journalism. Even here in Catalonia, in the European Union, in the northern part of the Mediterranean, freedoms are not warranted. Just three considerations about the freedom of speech. Freedom of speech is quite easy to obtain. You only need a constitution. And I know that in many Arab countries, that's very difficult. Most of them don't have a constitution. But most of them, at the same time, in the Arab Spring, like in Tunisia or in Egypt, they are drafting new constitutions. And some way of freedom of speech is going to be granted. Then we can take a look at where is going to be the limit. Then I think we must talk also about freedom of the press. And for freedom of the press, I understand the freedom that a private company has to publish any kind of news that it wants. And that's not easy. That's not easy because broadcasting rights, access to internet, distribution of of newspapers, that requires normally a permission by the authorities. So the authorities can't effectively prevent a news organization, a media company, from reaching this freedom of having freedom of the press and acquiring their exercise of freedom of speech. And then there is the freedom of information. And that's related, like Giovanna was saying, to the freedom of creativity, la creativité. That's the freedom that the journalist has in order to exercise the right to freedom of speech. So that's the individual. And that's very difficult to acquire. It's very difficult to exercise it, even here in Catalonia. That requires you not being afraid of your government, but at the same time, not being afraid of your own employee. Don't be afraid of losing your job for pushing your ideas, for just bringing to your readers the points of view that you think they need to know. The pressure is huge on the journalists in order to write what they want. And I remember in Tunisia in January 16, 2011, 2 days after the fall of the regime, I went to the Tunisian Press Association. There was a meeting there, 50 journalists, and the atmosphere was of sadness, shame for not having been able throughout the regime to bring out the news that other journalists, like for example Fahem Boukadous, that I think he's, I don't know if he's here.
Yeah.
Okay. He was in prison at the time, and people at this meeting were talking about him, and he was in prison because he had the courage to go to the south of Tunisia and report the conditions of the people living there and working there, and he was in prison for that. So there was a deep sense of shame and impotence of not having been able to live to the standards of the freedom of speech, the freedom of the press, and the freedom of information. And what we are seeing now in the Arab countries, and I want to emphasize the Arab countries, because we are here at the We always talk about the Arab countries, about the Mediterranean, south of the Mediterranean. I think it's an euphemism that we need to overcome. I think that we have to talk about the Arab countries because it's essential to understand for us that those are Arab countries with an identity, an Arab identity. It's not a Mediterranean identity. It's mainly an Arab identity. And I think as soon as we realize that, we'll be able to confront the problems those countries are facing in order to acquire a complete freedom of speech. We've seen in Tunisia demonstrations on the streets by journalists. We are seeing them also in Egypt now. Why? Because they are drafting constitutions that are going to be putting limits on the freedom of speech. And where those limits should be? In Catalonia, in Spain, during the transition, there was complete freedom of speech. Complete. There's only one limit. Terrorism. I remember that only one case of one newspaper being forbidden to print because it was linked to Basque terrorism. Only one linked to Basque terrorism, and it was a huge scandal when that newspaper was forced to close. That's the only limit. And now in the Arab countries, in Egypt, in Tunisia, it's like if you don't abide by the law of God, you're an apostate. There is room for secularism in an Arab democracy. I've been meeting people in Libya, in Lebanon, in Yemen. They were saying that we don't have any problem with our civil rights, we have problems with our political rights. Can they be, and they were asking, can we be good Muslims and vote for a secularist political party? Or do I have to vote for an Islamist political party? Can I keep religion in my private sphere of life? Or should religion be present in public life? It's not an easy question. We're talking about Islam. It's not a bit an easy question to answer from our point of view. No? But I think there should not be limit in order to use freedom of speech to insult religion. That happened in Spain. Spain is a very Catholic country. It was even more Catholic during the dictatorship. The Catholic Church is still today one of the huge powers of Spanish democracy. And at the same time, the constitution and the law has allowed this church to be criticized, heavily criticized. And you can find from bandes dessinées, comics to cartoons in newspaper to outspoken people who talk heavily against the church and the idea of gay marriage or how to build a family, etc., etc. And I think that that has reinforced our freedom. And from the Catalan Association of Journalists, we fight every day very hard in order to guarantee that journalists can exercise their right. And that means that we have to fight against the companies sometimes and against the government at the same time. And one thing that we've learned is that trade unionism and association are two essential tools in order to defend your rights. I know unionism is not allowed in many Arab countries, in the Persian Gulf, for example, but it's essential. Without trade unions, journalist trade unions, and heavily compromised journalist associations, the journalist is alone, and he won't be able to overcome the stronger position of governments and media companies. Thank you very much.